Welcome to this session. So in this session we will study isomerism. What is actually isomerism? Isomerism means they have the same molecular formula but different structure or spatial arrangement of atoms. Two things is there. One is the structural and second is the spatial arrangement. They have different physical and chemical properties. So these two is formula having the physical property also different and chemical properties also different. Physical properties will different, chemical properties will be in gradation order. Means it will be just a decreasing or increasing order. So broadly this isomerism, this compound is phenomena is divided into two types. Broadly one is the structural or constitutional isomerism, second is the stereoisomerism. So structural, constitutional. Constitutional means they have the different connectivities. While the stereoisomer means they have the structural formula, same structural formula, but their atoms are having different relative arrangement of atoms or groups in space. In the same, the atoms or groups having the different type of arrangement. While in this cases, so structures are only different, there is no talking about the relative arrangement in space. In this case, UPAC names are quite different. In this case, UPAC names are called in different ways. They are expressed in different way. Okay, but almost their UPAC names are same because they are the spatial arrangement. This is not a structural arrangement. So we'll discuss all this arrangement one by one. Come to structure. In a structure, we have different type of subgroups. That is chain isomerism, positional, functional, metamerism, ring chain tautomerism. In stereoisomerisms, again, we have two types. One is the configurational isomerism, second is the conformational isomerism. So, configurational isomerisms, they have the separable. These isomerisms are separable, means they cannot be converted to each other without breaking the bonds. If you break the bonds, they will convert. Otherwise, it is very difficult to separate this one. And conformational means they have the different configurations. Means these configurations is different due to the rotation. If you rotate this molecule, you will get the different conformations around a single bond. Rotation of this molecule around a single bond is possible. In this case, not possible. You have to break the bond. So under this, we have a geometrical isomerism. One is the optical isomerism. So optical isomerism, there is no bond restriction. In geometrical, we have the bond restriction. But both are configurational. In geometrical isomerisms, again, it is difficult to break this bond because they are having the double bond. And they are again named as a different nomenclatures or they are different types. One is the cis-trans type, one is the E and Z, second is sin and anti, exo and endo. We'll discuss one by one. In optical isomerisms, stereoisomerisms, in this case, atoms are arranged in a three-dimensional in space. And which create mirror image to each other. Means these isomers having these are mirror image to each other. They create. So under again mirror images, one is the exactly mirror image and second is the non-mirror image. Means their mirror image is not matching with the in these cases. But in this case, mirror image is matching. So in under opticals, we have two different type of isomers. One is mirror image, other is non-mirror image. We can also explain this, divide this isomerism, stereoisomers into two types. One is the enantiosomers, second is the distereoisomers. Means one who is forming the mirror image, another who is not forming the non-mirror image. And again, under distereomers, we can divide into two types. One is the configurational isomers, second is the cis-trans isomers. So this is the one type of classification. Now come to structural or constitutional isomers. So there are constitutional isomers due to different carbon skeleton, different position of functional group or different type of functional group. Let us see one by one. Chain isomers, they have different carbon skeletons. This is also called as the nuclear isomers. And they have different type of carbon skeleton in a chain. So and they always start from the four carbon. Means two carbon, three carbon, we cannot make the chain isomers. Let us take one example. This is a C5H12 pentane. So first take the longest carbon, 5 carbon, 4 carbon, 1 carbon is broken from here and is joined from this side. So it becomes isobutane, 3 carbon. Similarly, you can butane. Butane has 2 isomers. One is the 4 carbon chain and next is the 3 carbon chain. So always try to form the isomers by decreasing the number of carbon or increasing the number of carbon. So it is better you take the decreasing number of carbon. Similarly, if you take the hexane molecule, largest carbon chain is the 6 carbon chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now reduce number of chain, so we will get the 2 isomers, one is this side, one is this side. Again reduce the chain by 4 carbon, so 2 different group, 1 and 2 this carbon, opposite to each other. So again we have total 5 isomers. Similarly, C7H16 has 9 isomers, C8H18 has 18 isomers, nonin has 35 isomers, decane has 75 isomers. There are so many. So this will be helpful. Only we require concept to understand. By drawing the structure, we can derive this type of structure. There is no formula like things. The next isomer is the position isomer. In this, actually position of the substituted atom or group on the carbon skeleton is changing. And again, you have to note it down. Carbon change is fixed. What is the position of substituted atom? Position of substituent atoms means actually we talking about multiple bonds or functional groups. So it is changing. Let us take this functional group and multiple bonds. This is alkene. So this is the butane. So butane, you can see one double bond is second carbon and this double bond is first carbon. So there was second carbon and this is the first carbon. So again, they have two isomers. So position of the double bond has been changed. Similarly, in alkyne, triple bond is present at the first carbon, but in this case, triple bond is present at the second carbon. So there are two isomers. So these are the position isomers. Alcohol. So this is example of alcohol. So OH is attached to the first carbon, second OH is present at the second carbon. Two isomers. Similarly, C3H2O, this is the molecular formula of alkane. Propane, propanol. So again carbon first, again second. This is the primary alcohol, this is the secondary alcohol. Similarly, in case of amines, this is the primary amine, this is the secondary. This is the again primary amines at second carbon. If you take the secondary amine, so you can see the this secondary amine has 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So again, you can see. So they have chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, you can see you put nitrogen this side, again it becomes a position. Position of the nitrogen is in third position, now it is coming in the second position. So these two isomers is also called as the position isomers. Limitation, there are some limitations of the position isomers. Terminal functional group like aldehyde, carboxylic acid and their derivatives, CN, cyanide, they do not exhibit the position isomers. Remember, CHO, CO is carboxylic acid and their derivative, means COCl, CONH2, anhydride, all these cannot exhibit the position isomerism. Monosubstituted alicyclic compounds and aromatic compounds can also do not exhibit the position isomerism. So you see these are the aromatic compounds. So they are not the position isomer. Even ortho, meta, para, they are not the position isomerism. In this case also no position isomerism. They are just the same structure. Now take the functional isomer, next is. So in this case, atoms are rearranged to give the different functional group. Means this isomer consists of different type of functional group, means different atoms are present. Even name of the molecule also changes. Let us take the different class of the organic compound which exhibit the functional isomerism. Alcohols and ether. Its general formula is CnH2n plus alkene plus single oxygen. So this is taking example C2H6O. So this is your one propanol, again ether. You can see molecular formation, but their functional groups are different. So this is functional isomers. Next is aldehyde, ketone and unsaturated alcohol. Formula is alkene plus single oxygen. You have to remember alkene plus single oxygen. This is saturated hydrocarbon plus single oxygen. Alkene plus single oxygen. This formula is very important while solving the numericals in organic chemistry. So we have aldehyde, ketone and unsaturated alcohols. And fourth one is ether, other epoxy cyclic compounds. So we have this one, C3H6. This is the compound. This is the your aldehyde, ketones, epoxy compounds. And one we can also note it down. CH. We can take three compounds CH, and we can take one more compound CH and OH. So this is unsaturated alcohol. Means if you make double bond over here, and this is double bond is there, and CH2. So again, you can see. number of carbon is also same. This is called unsaturated alcohol. So we have four groups is present, 1, 2, 3 and 4. All these are functional isomers. Next is your monocarboxylic acid esters and hydroxycarbonyl compound. So alkene plus 2 oxygen. Alkene plus single oxygen is aldehyde, ketone, ketones and unsaturated alcohols. So in this case, again, example is, this is a carboxylic acid, this is your ester, this is ester groups, and this is the hydroxycarbonyl. One ketone, this and one alcohol. So carbonyl plus hydroxy, both are present in this compound. So these are the hydroxycarbonyl compounds. Next functional isomers are alkynes and alkadienes. So you can say triple bond is there. Again, triple bond can be converted into two double bonds. So these are the dienes group. So triple bond and double bond. Similarly, this is the 3 carbon and this is the, again 3 carbon. So this is called, also called as the allele. So again, these two are different type of functional isomers. Next, we have cyanides and isocyanide. Isocyanide is written as a NC and this is CN. You can see example, ethane nitride and isocyanide. So this methyl is attached with the carbon N. Nitroalkane NO2 and alkyl nitrite ONO. So carbon attached with the nitrogen and in this case carbon attached with the oxygen. So this is the ethyl nitrite and this is the nitroalkane. Primary, secondary, tertiary amines are also functional isomers. So you can see the primary amine, this is secondary amine, this is the tertiary amine. Aromatic alcohols, phenols and ethers, these are also a functional isomer. You can see this is the ortho, meta and paracresol phenol. So this group CH3 can be written over here. If you're writing over this side, this is ortho. If you're writing this side, meta, and this is the para. This can be also written in form of, this is anisole. Anisole is a ether. This is the benzyl alcohol, aromatic alcohol. So we have again three type of compounds. All these are functional isomers. Again, next is your amides and oximes. Oxime is NOH. This group, when nitrogen is double bonded with the carbon, this is it will become say acetaldoxime. So this group is called as oxime and CONH2 is called amide. So amide and acetaldoxime is the functional isomers. Thioalcohols and thioethers. Thioalcohols means the compound must have SH group. So when it has SH group, it's called thio. This is thioalcohol and this is called as the thioethers. Now we are going to deal with the next isomers, structural isomer, that is called metamerism. So they have a different number of carbons, atoms or alkyl groups on either side of the functional group or polyvalent atom. Polyvalent atoms, you can take oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen, which have more than one valencies. And phenomena of this isomers is called as the metamerism. And these isomers are metamers. It is occurring among the members of the same homologue family. Let us see some examples. So this is the oxygen, and from oxygen you can see there are two carbon, there are two carbon. This is the another metamers. This side one carbon, this side one, two and three carbon. So you can see around the functional group, this is a functional group. So this side is one carbon, this side three carbon, this side two carbon, two carbon. So these two metamers are different. You can write this carbon as a this. So if you put this carbon over here, this become branching. So these two are position isomers. These two are not a metamers. These two are, again I am repeating, these two are not a metamers, but they are position isomers. Position metamers means the number of carbon around the polyvalent atom should be different. But in this case, both are same. So these are position isomers. All three are position isomers, but there are two metamers. Similarly, it is happening with the thio. This is thio ether. Same. So these two are again position isomers, but all these two are metamers. Again, same here. These two are metamers in case of secondary amine. This is in case of ketone. These two are again this and this is same. So these two are position isomers. This one and this one having the same type of carbon on each side of the this functional group. Again, you can see these two are again. You can say metamers, but these three are your position isomers. 1, 2, 3 are position isomers, but these are metamers. Similarly, this is examples. In this examples, you can see these two are again metamers. So around the oxygen or around the this one, this is changing this position and it is coming this side. So only this is changing. So this group is different. This group is different. So one is, it will come this side. You can see. So again, this example is also a example of metamers.